Hello students, previously in the yesterday's class we have discussed some part of the lesson tsunami. So now we shall try to continue it. Fine. Okay, now we will start with the next paragraph. The Smith later met other tourists who had lost their entire families. Thanks to Lily and her geography lesson, they had been forewarned. Tilly went back to her school in England and told her classmates her terrifying tale. Tale means story. So here, forewarned means inform someone of a possible future danger or problem. Means informing previously means the danger is about to come. Then the person Tilly got to know that the danger is going to arrive. So she warned before only. Okay, the description of this paragraph is, the Smith family later got the chance of meeting other tourists who had lost their entire families during the tsunami. All credit to Tilly and her geography lesson that they were forewarned. Tilly later retold the incident to her classmates in England. Okay. Before the giant waves slammed into the coast in India and Sri Lanka, wild and domestic animals seemed to know what was about to happen. They fled to safety. According to eyewitness accounts, elephants screamed and ran for higher ground. Dogs refused to go outdoors. Flamingos abandoned their low-lying breeding areas, and zoo animals rushed into their shelters and could not be enticed to come back out. Slammed in the suns, hit something with great force and fled means run away from a place or situation of danger. And eyewitness means a person who has seen something happen and can give a first hand description of it. Okay, enticed in the sense attract or attempt by offering pleasure or advantage. So here comes the explanation of this paragraph. It is believed that prior to the gigantic waves entering the coast of India and Sri Lanka, wild and domestic animals knew what was ahead. This is because they ran out of danger's way to someone safe. A few eyewitnesses gave a first-hand description of how elephants ran for higher ground as they screamed. Flamingos too left their low-lying breeding grounds. Zoo animals ran into their shelters and no amount of temptation was able to bring them out. Okay. Lastly, even dogs refused to go outdoors. Means dogs refused to come outside of their shelter. Okay. Many people believed that animals possess a sixth sense and know when the earth is going to shake. Some experts believe that animals more acute hearing helps them to hear or feel the earth's vibration. They can sense an approaching disaster long before humans realize what's going on. We cannot be sure whether animals have a sixth sense or not. But the fact is that the giant waves that rolled through the Indian Ocean killed many more 150,000 people in a dozen countries. But not many animals have been reported dead. Okay. Sixth sense means a supposed intuitive faculty giving awareness or not explicable in terms of normal perception, and acute hearing means reacting readily to stimuli or impressions. That means sensitive, very sensitive. Okay, the description or the explanation of this paragraph is, it is well known among people that many animals are intuitive towards the earth shaking. Yes, you might have heard that. Some of you, the elder persons of your home, will be telling that dogs will get to know very early when earthquake or flood is going to happen. So that's have been told in the story. Okay. Some experts are of the opinion that they can hear or feel Earth's vibration in advance because they possess enhanced acute hearing abilities. That is why they can perceive an approaching disaster a lot earlier than humans. It is quite obvious that we cannot say surely that animals are intuitive and can sense the disaster early on, but the evidence is quite point towards it. Fact says that gigantic waves of the Indian Ocean took 150,000 human lives, but not many animals were reported dead. Okay, there were the reports of death of humans, but there was not any harm to the animals being dead. Okay, coming to next paragraph. Along India's Cuddalore coast, where thousands of people perished, buffaloes, goats and dogs were found unharmed. The Yala National Park in Sri Lanka is home to a variety of animals, including elephants, leopards and 130 species of birds. 60 visitors were washed away from the Pattanagala beach inside the park, but no animal carcasses were found except for two water buffaloes. About an hour before the tsunami hit, people at Yala National Park had observed three elephants running away from the Pattanagala beach. Okay, perished in the sense die, especially in a violent or sudden way, and carcasses means the dead body of an animal. Okay, the explanation comes here. At India's Cuddalore coast, where the waves took the lives of around 1,000 of people, animals like buffaloes, goats and dogs were also recovered unharmed. On the other hand, in Yala National Park in Sri Lanka, 60 visitors got taken away by the water, while no animals were harmed except two water buffaloes. So this was the report which came after the tsunami. A point to be noted here is that Yala National Park serves as a home to a large number of animals like elephants, leopards and around 130 species of birds. In fact, people present at Yala National Park reported seeing three elephants run away from Pattanagala beach at least an hour before the waves came in. Means they have the sixth sense, they can observe what the things are going to happen in future. Moving to next paragraph. A Sri Lankan gentleman who lives on the coast near Galle said his two dogs would not go for their daily run on the beach. They are usually excited to go on this outing, he said, but on that day they refused to go and most probably saved his life. Fine. So this was the lesson we have gone through, tsunami. So I hope you are clear with the lesson. Okay, you may go through the textbook. I have read all the paragraphs one by one and I have explained them. Fine. Now, in the next class. Fine. Okay, we'll see in the next class itself. Okay. Bye, goodbye. Have a nice day.